So let's vary the rule that generates the Koch curve a little bit and see what happens. So here's the program again. Go down and select snap to grid. And I'm going to move the points around. So let's see here. So then I'm going to get something that's going to make a Koch curve. There it is. Okay. So there's that shape. And let's see, I can move this up a little bit. Then we get a pointier Koch curve. I can move this up even more. Then it'll get a really pointy curve. Starts to overflow itself, or to overwrite itself. So another thing one can do is put a little bit of asymmetry in here. So instead of having this be centered, I can move this point over there, and then we get an interesting shape like that. And that, even though this is still a deterministic rule, here, let me put that in, is starting to look much more realistic, more like a real coastline or a jagged rock or torn piece of paper or something. So a little bit of irregularity in the rule, something that's not quite symmetric, can make things pretty interesting. And I would encourage you to play around with other possibilities. And you can do even more if you have more points to play around with. So I'm just going to give you a feel for what one could do. Could put a bump like this. Then we could do a bigger bump down there. So let's see what this looks like. Again, something pretty jagged and rough. So I would suggest, if you're at all inclined, to play around with this program or a similar one on the web, and just kind of get a feel for how a simple rule with a little bit of regularity in it. So the simple rule, again, is that we're replacing every line segment with a sort of wiggly line segment. When it's bent like that, if we iterate that rule, we get this funny sort of shape. You can even change the position of these points on the fly, and I found that it's a little hard to know what's going on when I do that, but it's still fun. And the main point here is that this very simple iterative process can lead to a pretty wide array of different looking fractals.